Rahim. Welcome back, my dear students. Today I'm going to present you the third type of delta modulation called delta sigma modulation. This type of delta modulation overcomes all the problems we faced in the delta modulation and in the adaptive delta modulation. As we mentioned in the previous two lectures, we have two problems or three problems. First, two problems are called quantization error, which includes slope overload distortion when the input signal is large, so the output of the integrator cannot catch this changing of the input signal. And the second called the granular noise, the input signal is flat and the step size or the output of the integrator is large. These two problems, granular noise and slope overload distortion, are called quantization error. The third, these two problems, the quantization error, we overcome by using adaptive delta modulation, in which we used a control logic, which was the changing the output of the D bistable device, Q output, if it monitors or watches three same values of the output, the same value, 0 or 1, let's turn on the counter and try to increase the gain of the integrator in order to catch the changing of the input signal. But as I mentioned in the previous lecture, still we have the problem that the adaptive delta modulation cannot pass the DC voltage signals, which are very important for video system application. But in the case of voice communication, this is not a problem. There's no problem. The granular noise and stop overload distortion and DC voltage, these problems are not considered as a problem in the case of voice communication, but they are constant in the case of the video applications. So today I'm going to talk about delta sigma modulation, which overcomes all the problems we mentioned in the previous two techniques. So we have just added integrator prior to delta modulator. The integrator here before the delta modulator. The main function of the integrator, by adding the integrator or by integrating the message signal before prior to the delta modulator, This integrator has three advantages. The main advantage which we are looking for, we are trying to meet the low frequency of the signal. Low frequency content of the message signal is pre-emphasized, so it passed the low frequency content of the message signal. Correlation between the adjacent samples is increased, so in this case, increasing the overall system performance of the system of the delta sigma modulation by reducing the variance of the error signal at the input of the quantizer. And the third one, the receiver system, the receiver block diagram will be simplified. So we have here the integrator. Then we have the hard limiter. Hard limiter is a voltage comparator with its inverting input tied to zero. So the input signal is applied to the non-inverting input. If the input signal M of T more than zero, positive values, so the output of the hard limiter will be plus 5 volt. If the input of the message signal to the non-inverting input negative value, then the output will be 0 volt. So then we have the pulse generator, which generates the clock signals, and here we have the multiplier. Then we have the feedback system, message signal plus minus with the output of the feedback system. Here, this is the block diagram of the transmitter or modulator of delta sigma modulator. If we're talking about integration of the message signal prior to the delta modulator, in the receiver, we have to add the differentiation function in order to cancel the function of the integrator. But as we know, in the block diagram of the delta modulation, we have integrator in the conventional delta modulation by itself. So we have the effect of differentiator will be cancelled by the integrator used in the block diagram of the conventional delta modulator. So we don't have to eat anything here. The effect of differentiator will be eliminated. We will have simply the receiver just low pass filter in order to remove the repel or to remove the repel of the out of the integrator. We're talking about the ramp up and down of the, in order to smooth out the signal. This is the final function in order to have the message signal, which is the estimated value of the message signal, to cancel the effect of the ramp up and down by the integrator. So this is the main function of the tricyclic moduleta, which overcomes all the problems we faced in the previous one. Just we added here the integrator, which can a priori to the delta moduleta. This is the block diagram delta moduleta, but here we use, instead of voltage comparator, we have some device called hard limiter or zero constant detector. Zero constant detector, hard limiter, we have the inverting input just tied to zero. I hope you will understand this lecture, enjoy this lecture, because it's very simple. And by this technique, we overcome all the problems we mentioned previously, quantization error, which included slope overload distortion and granular noise, and DC voltage components. Thank you for following me. See you in the next lecture.